from the studios of Foxborough Cable Access, located in the center of Foxborough, Massachusetts, you are watching Around Foxborough.
Hello and welcome to Around Foxborough, the show where we learn about the people, places, and things that make Foxborough the gem of Norfolk County. My name is Mark Rivard, and I am pleased to have as my guest today, Wes Woodson. Welcome, Wes.
Hello. Thank you for having me so much.
Well, you've been on the show before. Although it was with Jury, you know, but it was a whole different topic. Now you're going to talk about a book that you have coming out.
A book is coming out that I could not be more excited to share about.
Wow. And it's called The Anxiety Advantage.
Correct.
Tell us a little bit about what we can expect from this book. What's it all about?
Of course. So, like, you know, for me personally, I always wish there was a book, like a magical book that told it like it was in terms of how to better manage your anxiety. And it really stems from my own desire, because for me, I have always struggled with anxiety. I think we can all relate to it. Actually, anxiety is one of the most common mental health disorders you can actually have. And for me, always being kind of, you know, struggling with self-acceptance, self-love, I always had anxiety. It was always there. But it wasn't until I was a freshman in college where I kind of had the biggest panic attack ever. And that was kind of, it threw me down a very, very deep, dark down, deep. Oh, I'm sorry. Is my dog in the background?
It's 2020 Zoom. Dogs are allowed.
Literally. It threw me down a very dark hole into a very, very anxious and dark place. I was depressed. And I went to the hospital. And actually, it was a very, very, very dark time I was in. And when I was at the hospital, they gave me three options, right? They gave me one, I can go see my therapist. Two, I can go to an inpatient program, which essentially being in the hospital receiving intensive care. Or the third option was an outpatient program. And the outpatient program was essentially me going to this place, this mental health facility, for 9 hours a day. I called it anxiety school because it was like going to school. And I learned how to better manage my anxiety. And in that program, I met all these cool kids who suffered from anxiety, depression, self-harm. And a light bulb went off. And I was like, okay, I'm not the only one who suffers from anxiety, right? And mind you, I have friends back at school who have anxiety. And they would give us all these handouts during the anxiety school sessions. And I wish I could just take that folder and give it to my friends who suffer from anxiety. But I couldn't do that because there would be no correct context. So I was like, why not write a book? And that was kind of the idea, the light bulb that went off, of taking everything I learned in anxiety school, how to better manage your anxiety, and give it to someone else who could use it. And that's been the driving force behind the whole book. And I'm excited that it will be publishing April 2021. It has happened, I mean, by God's grace, it has happened this fast. I literally could not imagine it going any other way. Because of the pandemic, I had nothing but time to write. that's kind of what has made it go a little faster. But yes, so it's expected to publish in April 2021.
Wow, that's awesome. I most people would, during the pandemic, they were doing puzzles, playing video games. And you were writing.
Yes.
You had a purpose. That's great. And a lot of people do struggle with anxiety. I have family members. We've all gone through it.
Right.
Even if it's just for a brief period of time, but to really have a bad case of anxiety can really cripple you, especially, like you said, when you're going to school and you're starting college. And college is a big jump from high school. It's a totally different universe.
Big jump. It's really crazy. I mean, honestly, I remember the first night before I was going to move into college, I had a panic attack. I had a panic attack. I wasn't ready for the big change. Like you said, it's a big leap. It's a big jump. I wasn't ready for that. And I always, you know, went to therapy. My mom is actually a mental health therapist. So I kind of grew up around the world of mental health. And I have found coping mechanisms, positive ones, and, you know, unfortunately, negative ones that I'm trying to work on and get rid of. But for the most part, I didn't really have a strong understanding of my anxiety. Like, what made me anxious? Why am I nervous right now? And I tried searching high and low for books for it. And I was sick and tired of reading the books from like Tony Robbins and Tim Ferriss of the world. Like, I'm 22 years old. That man is probably like 30 years my senior. So I wanted to hear from someone like me. So I figured, why not make it myself? And that was kind of the goal.
Well, anxiety is different in in everybody's case. And yes. especially, like you said, somebody who's 30 years older than you, like I am.
Right.
I don't have the same anxieties that somebody who's in their 20s does today,
yes.
especially with the economy, with
right.
the COVID-19 virus, with all different pressures, with the internet, with, you know, the texting. I mean, yeah, I have that now, but
yes.
your generation grew up with it. That's all you know.
Yes, exactly.
It's different.
That's exactly what I talk about in the book. Literally, like, the book is split up into three sections. One, it's like what, like my personal story, and actually interview many other people's stories too. And the second is the why. And in the why, we talk about why is my generation, Generation Z, so nervous. And like you just said, it's because we're addicted to social media. We strive for perfectionism in academia and in schools. We have all these social pressures that we have to be the solvers of tomorrow's problems. And what that does to us is it creates a large amount of anxiety, a large amount. And how do we handle that? That's the last part of the book, is the how. And I outline six principles that would essentially help to answer, you know, those questions that we have.
Well, not to give away the book, but if you could give one example of one of those, just
yes.
one.
Yes.
We just want to give a little tease. We don't want to give out, you know, the whole book. Teaser.
So, I'm not sure, Mark. Are you a basketball fan?
I'm a fan of all sports.
All sports. Okay, great. So are you familiar with the Dream Team? Michael Jordan, Magic Johnson?
Oh, I grew up with that. That was 1992. Yeah.
Perfect, right? So you have Michael Jordan, you have Larry Bird, you have Magic Johnson, right? I mean, those are the top three players I remember from that team. I was not alive during that time, but I still go back and I'm a basketball fiend. But I think there's something very important to be told when looking at that example of the Dream Team, right? When you have a team, you have players, you have a coaching staff. And I think basically in the mental health world and in the world of anxiety, it's not any different. You have to build your dream team. For me, the players are my friends. My coach is my therapist. You know what I mean? And this idea of when you build that strong support system, that is one of the first steps you can take to getting a better grasp of your anxiety. So that's kind of the first thing I learned in anxiety school, is of building that dream team. And that's what I kind of outlined in the book. So that's like one little bit teaser about it.
Okay. Yeah. Like I said, I don't want you to give away the whole thing. So I want people to go out and buy this book.
Yes.
And just so you know, I think somewhere I have this thing. You may be familiar. It's ancient. It's called a videotape. And I actually have a videotape of Larry Bird's last game that he ever played, which
really?
Was with the Dream Team.
Whoa.
Before he retired.
Whoa, so you're a lucky fan. You're
oh yeah, lucky. I'm a big Celtics fan, so
ah.
And a Larry Bird fan. So, you know, just to not to go off on a tangent, but you know, he was the guy when I was growing up. I watched him from his first day as a Celtic all the way up to the end. So
really?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm old.
You don't look it, brother. You don't.
Thank you. It checks in the mail.
I appreciate it.
So what are you doing now? I mean, are you working? Tell everybody what you're up to.
Yeah, so I graduated from Babson College in May, mm-hmm. right? And I think everyone who graduated in 2020, they're like, what's next? The fortunate part for me is, like, when I was at Babson, I actually started a clothing company. I'm actually wearing a piece of it now. It's called The Hidden Company.
Mm-hmm.
And it's clothing with a mission, right? And the mission behind that was to empower people to never feel the way that I once did, which was, quote unquote, hidden. I wanted to empower people to be their true selves unapologetically. And I kind of started selling hoodies and t-shirts, and word kind of organically spread around campus, and it has grown. And I'm glad that it is one of the ways that I make money now. You know? And I still, it's kind of like my full-time job. But on top of that, I do public speaking engagements, and I write the book full-time. Like I said, because of the pandemic, I'm inside, I'm stuck in my room, I'm just writing on my laptop. So those three things I do. I run the clothing company, public speaking, and the book are what I'm doing right now currently.
Are you actually thinking of another book, even though this one's not out? Have you already started? Or
For me, I always go by like a chief storyteller. That's like my bio on my LinkedIn. I love storytelling. So the book is just phase one, right? It's phase one. I got some more books in me, but I want to make sure the first one's right, you know?
Yeah. Well, that's great. That's awesome. And I did notice mm-hmm. that 50% of the proceeds from the Hidden Co.
Yes.
I donated to the National Alliance on Mental Illness.
Yes.
Which is
yes.
awesome.
Thank you. That was something that was very, very near and dear to my heart, because I think as a man, like, you don't converse about mental illness at all. Like, you're not told to. I mean, we aren't told to be vulnerable about our anxiety or our pain or our sufferings. And I wanted to use my platform with my startup, my clothing company, to shed light on something that men and females face. I mean, everyone faces this.
Oh yeah.
Why can't we talk about it? You know? So yeah, everything that I sell, 50% goes to NAMI. And I stand by that. And I want to do more of that. So thank you for mentioning that. I forgot to plug that in.
Well, it's important. I mean, you said it best. People don't talk about it. The more people talk about it, the more things get done about it.
Exactly. Because there's this big stigma around it, right? And I just want to do the biggest thing I possibly can on my part to just push a dent in that stigma. Even if it's a little bit, you know, just a little bit.
Hey, every little bit helps.
Thank you. I can't
wait to read the book.
Yes. Really? And it's funny you said that, because actually, even though the book is going to come out in April, the pre-sale launches this week. So this week, the book is available for pre-sale on this Friday.
Where is it available for pre-sale? Come on, you got a plug.
I got you. I love this. But it will be available for pre-sale at www.westwoodson.com.
Wow.
And yes, on Friday. So be on the lookout.
Awesome. And for people who don't know, didn't see you on your previous visit to our studios, mm-hmm. or our virtual studios as they were, you also grew up in Sharon.
Yes,
Right down the street.
Now, I have to be honest. I pride myself of being authentic and truthful. I moved. So I'm out in Easton.
You moved miles and miles away.
Miles away.
Maybe I'll catch a flight one day and see you.
So not too far away.
You're still in the area. So I mean, that's, you know, and you've been here ever since. That's awesome.
Yes. But thank you so much for having me on the show. Continuing. I love coming back here and just sharing good news and just vibing.
Well, I can't wait to have you back again when you have your next book and your feature film and, you know.
Ooh.
Gotta reach for the stars, right?
I love it. Yes. I will be back here very soon, I promise.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much, Wes, for being with us. And I look forward to reading your book. And that is called The Anxiety Advantage, coming out in April.
Yes. But for available for pre-sale.
Available pre-sale.
This Friday.
So make sure you go out and get it.
Yes.
Thank you. And that'll do it for another episode of Around Foxborough. Hope you have yourself a great day.